Hi. So in today's lecture, we're going to be talking about how to evaluate solo activities. So hopefully you can pull out your short writing assignment about polar bears from the lecture on this from last week, and we'll talk about how we can evaluate these. So remember that solo taxonomy stands for Structured Observations of Learning Outcomes. And where you should have written this little activity about how polar bears are adapted to their environment. So you can print out this rubric that looks like this, starting with this pre-structural, unistructural, multistructural, and then on to relational and extended abstracts. It also can look like this. And I like this rubric because it has the transitional responses with the 0.5, so we can be a little more flexible in how we assess these. And I'm just scrolling through these. We'll talk in more detail when we get to this page because I really think it's maybe a little more clear. So let's talk about what these look like. So in the pre-structural response, this is a response that really doesn't have any idea what's kind of happening. The evidence that they're using to support their claim is really illogical and it doesn't make sense. So, for example, in the polar bear response, if you said, well, polar bears are adapted to their environment because, they drink Coca-Cola, like in that advertisement, and they're really happy, that really has nothing to do with actual polar bears in real life, right? So, if you said something about Coca-Cola polar bears, then you would be in that pre-structural, you would get a zero, right? The unidimensional response, this is a score of a one. This is where you only used one piece of evidence. So you took one piece of evidence and you ran with it. So you said polar bears are adapted to their environment because they have fur that keeps them warm from the cold. One piece of evidence, that's it, and you draw a conclusion. Or polar bears are not adapted to their environment because it's really cold in the Antarctic and they're dying. Okay, so one piece of evidence and they reached a conclusion. A multistructural is where you have two or more pieces of evidence, but they're not related to each other. So you can say polar bears are adapted to their environment because they have really warm coats for the cold and they have really sharp claws to catch fish, so they're related to their environment. Two things, but they didn't relate them to each other. Or two or more. We could talk about other factors too. They also have sharp teeth and they have good eyesight to see the fish. Okay, so I've talked about lots of different ways that polar bears are adapted to their environment, but they didn't relate to each other. The third one, relational, is where I've been able to take all of those pieces of evidence and relate them to each other to reach that conclusion. So I could talk about how the polar bear has black skin because it reflects it absorbs the heat of the sun, but then their coat is white and it blends in with the snow, and those two pieces of their outer covering helps them adapt to their environment really, really well. And I could talk about how their sharp claws and their sharp teeth work together to capture their prey, and that works with their limbs, which are good for swimming, right? So all of these things work together to help them adapt to their environment. So all of these things are related to each other. And really, most of our students tend to be in that two or three range, right? So mostly what we'd expect from students as they understand concepts is to be in that multistructural or relational areas. Extended abstract is really advanced, and we wouldn't necessarily expect students to reach that extended abstract area. Only our most gifted students, and really, like, we're talking a lot of times we don't reach this area until we're in our PhD programs and our advanced master's programs, where we're really able to kind of take lots of areas and apply it in new ways. And this is where I'm thinking about true logical deduction. I'm able to take counter arguments and place them and I'm not reaching a foregone conclusion. So I might say, you know, in a lot of ways, polar bears are adapted to their environment and in relational ways. But then I might think, you know, but the world's changing. We have global warming now, and we're seeing polar bears dying. So maybe they're not as adapted to their environment as they used to be. So now I'm taking in some counter evidence and also talking about that in this extended abstract way. So you can kind of see how all four of these levels are related to each other. And just I'm going to take a couple more notes on these solo activity questions and how we can talk about them. So the important thing here when you're talking about formulating a question for your solo activity, you really want to make sure that it's providing not only an open-ended question, but an argument that they can make. So it needs to be open-ended, but it also needs to have them prepare an argument with evidence. So, for example, in Romeo and Juliet, is Friar Lawrence a tragic hero? I would have to really understand the play Romeo and Juliet. I'd have to know understand the idea of a tragic hero and be able to collect evidence from the play and from Shakespeare's life in order to really understand and be able to answer that question. So make sure that your solo response question is asking for evidence in addition for it to it being open response. And that concludes this short lecture on how to evaluate solo taxonomy questions. I look forward to reading your labs this week. Bye.